I'm Eli Harari. I got my PhD in 1973 in solid-state sciences. I'm currently chairman and CEO of Sandisk Corporation, a public company located in Milpitas, California. A successful inventor basically recognizes a deficiency or some kind of a need and comes up with a solution and files a patent. Ideas are great, but ideas are really a dime a dozen. Taking that one idea that is going to change the world and actually changing the world is what an entrepreneur strives to achieve. When I came to Princeton in 1969, this was the year that America landed on the moon. And it was a very exciting time. My research work at Princeton was basically to try to understand why electronic devices in satellites were failing after a very short time in space. The laws of physics that applied to radiation effects in space on early semiconductor devices turned out to be very much the same physics that later on I applied in flash memory technology. What we found at SanDisk is that the technology was there. We had developed it. It was ready to go. Digital cameras were there to take advantage of the storage technology in flash that we had created. But the markets weren't there. The consumers weren't ready. The price was too high. Most importantly, the entire ecosystem, the infrastructure, wasn't there. It was really 1999, 5-6 years later, when the internet came on the scene, the web, and people suddenly realized that they didn't need to print their pictures, that they could just send them, by email. Suddenly, the infrastructure fell into place and people, flocked to stores and everybody wanted the digital cameras. We've gone from $50 per megabyte to 2 cents per megabyte in the space of 18 years, and that has made flash memory so affordable and so pervasive through so many applications, and all based on really technology that I learned about and really developed doing my PhD research work at Princeton. Flash is now in literally thousands of different applications. In the last 35 years, I have about 130 patents. The only way you can push innovation is to try to obsolete yourself. Everything that we've done until today, consider it obsolete. Try to obsolete yourself, because if you don't, others will do it to you. No matter how fast you run, you can never stop. You can never rest on your laurels. You should always be working on the next three generations of technology. My wife and I have endowed the graduate student fellowship. It's the least I could do to pay back Princeton by enabling other students, talented students from around the world, to come and benefit from this phenomenal institution. My name is Eli Harari, and I'm a Princeton engineer.